Today we're standing here at the Eastern Scald estuarine. This estuarine faces major problems with a process called sand starvation. In the 1980s, we constructed the storm surge barrier, which protects the southern part of the Netherlands against flooding. But due to the construction of this dam, we saw a reduction of the tidal currents and tidal flow. This has an impact on the morphology of the system. Due to this reduced energy, there is a continuous erosion of the tidal flats, whereas there's not enough energy to place the sand back from the gullies onto the tidal flat. Tidal flats are important for several reasons. One is safety and the other one is biodiversity. If you have a tidal flat like this one connected to the dike, what we see is that the tidal flat themselves, they reduce wave energy. And with such a tidal flat in front, dikes need to be less reinforced to protect the hinterland against flooding. They're also important for biodiversity. They are a feeding ground for migratory birds, and they also provide resting areas for seals. To protect these tidal flats against erosion, we investigated if oyster reefs could be an interesting building with nature tool. So let's have a look. So we're now standing at a natural oyster reef. Here you see an example of a small natural oyster reef. They're very interesting because they make this 3D structure. And with having this 3D structure, they change the way water flows over them. So if waves travel over a reef, they become smaller and the reef attenuates the wave energy. And while doing this, it also changes the sediment deposition behind the reef. What you see here is that you see this reef, and I'm standing on this area which is a little bit more elevated compared to the surrounding of the reef. And oysters are known as being ecosystem engineers, so by altering the water flow, they change the sediment, so they change their own environment. We want to make use of this quality of oysters to use them as a building with nature solution. We also apply this quality of these oysters in an artificial reef. So we're going to see how that looks like on a larger scale. Oysters need hard substrate in order to create these 3D structures, reefs, which we can use as a building with nature solution. So in order to get an oyster reef here at a very high dynamic location, what we did is we constructed an artificial reef using gabions. Inside those gabions, we placed oyster shell material from the Pacific oyster Crassostia gigas. This oyster is an invasive species to this area. It was introduced in the 1960s for aquaculture purpose, and afterwards it established itself throughout the whole estuarine. And we're making use of this invasive species because every year it recruits, and these recruits can settle on the substrate we offer here. And by having multiple years of recruitment, it becomes a living, self-sustainable reef, which can add to tidal flat protection in this erosive area. In order to understand if this reef can be a self-sustainable reef, we have to monitor how it's developing. So what we do is looking every year at how much the reef grown over time. So where we started was over here. This is what the initial height was of the artificial structure. And due to natural recruitment events, we have every year an extra layer of shell on top. And oysters, when they look for a suitable substrate to settle on, they cement themselves. So oysters cement themselves on top of each other, forming this package of oyster shells. And that's also making this a nice building with nature solution, because due to natural recruitment event, this structure is able to grow with sea level rise. We can still see some gabions over here. This has to do with the location. We're a very high hydrodynamic location, and the front of the reef needed some extra maintenance. So we added this extra structure to provide this stable substrate for oysters to settle on. And you can see it's already integrating into the reef further on. So yearly we visit in winter this oyster reef to measure how many recruitments settle on this reef structure. But we also measure the length of the oysters to understand how much they grow in time. So what we do, we measure them the total length, which gives us an indication how much they can grow and how much in total the reef can accrete. Furthermore, we monitor how efficient artificial reefs are in stabilizing the tidal flat and protecting it against erosion. So what we do on a yearly basis is we measure the height development of this area. And therefore we use this DGPS, which will allow us to monitor morphological changes on the level of 1 centimeter accuracy. Up to now we see that the reef is able to affect the morphology and reduce erosion over a large distance of 100 up to 300 meters behind the reef. Oyster reefs have shown that they can successfully reduce tidal flat erosion. However, success of delivering this service depends on system settings. Therefore, system knowledge is important to successfully be able to build with nature.